I am Bijo Olomeni, and with me here, our in-house analyst, Patrick Atoaya.
Welcome.
So Patrick, what is on our radar this morning?
The state government spending this morning, vis-a-vis the recent slide in our oil prices. As everyone knows, oil is down some 30% since June, and it's beginning to show in the ability of our states to finance their budgets this year and beyond. Now, the federal government says it's going to remove $2 billion from the excess food account to help shore up revenues for this year, for this month, going to the states, to be shared across the states and local governments. So what's interesting is we just got this new data from the NBS, right, showing the ITR position, that's internally generated position of all the states, well, the states that have reported for 2013. And the picture looks really bad, right? So we're seeing that probably 90-95% of Nigerian states are not able to adjust to this falling oil prices without there being a crisis triggered in their respective states, vis-a-vis ability to pay salaries and you know, recurrent expenditure, even capital expenditure will suffer. So that's what we're looking at.
Why are states so dependent on their oil revenues?
Well, it's a little bit historical. It also has to do with the fact that states have not tried to diversify their economies away from oil, right? So their tax issues, refuse states apply, you know, taxes. Very few citizens in all these various states pay taxes. The issues of just the know-how, right? How do you even go about designing a tax scheme that can respond to what is happening to your environment, right? So how do you design it? If you're a largely agrarian or a largely informal state with a lot of traders, how do you design a tax scheme that, you know, the people in your state are keen into? So those are some of the problems that we're seeing with the states.
Okay, what is the implication?
Well, the implication is quite there's a lot of implications for Nigeria and also for the states. First of all, we have the issue that, you know, government spending, right? So, like in Nigeria, we have to run a federal system. So you have the three-tier federal, state, and local government. And the state and local government, they make up about almost 50% of government spending, maybe about 48%. So what it means is that if the states are unable, if oil prices continue to fall and it begins to affect the state's ability to serve to finance their budgets, then we're going to see a huge cut in both recurrent and capital expenditures in the states. Also, what that means is that the government spend is going to take a hit, and GDP is going to take a hit, because, you know, GDP is usually defined as gross domestic product. Makes up, you know, the expenditure part. You use a government spending plus consumption, you know, plus exports and imports. You know, so the G part of that, the government spending, will take a hit and might shave off a couple of points of GDP. But another interesting thing is that the states are so tapped out that they cannot even, you know, most of them cannot borrow from either the bond market or from banks, because of a lot of them already have a huge debt profile. So there's really no way for them to mitigate this, you know, impact of sliding oil prices. There's also the issue of, you know, potential social unrest right now. If the states cannot pay salaries, if they cannot borrow, there'll be more unrest in most of these states.
Who is doing the best and the worst?
Okay, well, as usual, we have most states are doing very badly, right? But within those doing badly, you have your usual suspects. So you have states in the northeast and northwest that are not doing very well. Even north central states are not doing very well when you look at IGR as a percentage of their total budget. Now, the worst that I've seen so far is Zamfara, whose IGR is only about 3% of its total budget of 104 billion. So they have an IGR of 3 billion, right? They have a budget of 104 billion. So they're doing just 3%, or conversely, if you say 97% of their budget is funded from oil revenues, or you know, revenues from the center, while only 3% is funded from the net generated revenues. On the flip side, Lagos State is still by far the best performer, having about 75% of their budget, up to 384 billion naira, coming from internal resources, or into like VAT, you know, taxes, and other fees that they impose on the businesses in the states. What this does for Lagos is that it gives it the ability to withstand any prolonged fall in oil prices, because even if the revenues from the center begins to dwindle really badly, they can still budget up to 75-80% of their budget of last year. They can budget it next year, and they'll be confident that they can raise most of those revenues internally without having to, you know, worry about what the oil prices are doing.
Thanks for watching Business District Logic. Until we come next time, happy journal meeting. Bye.